So hello and welcome to another episode of The Way to Be. I'm Frederick Dunn, and although I'd normally be talking about honeybees, this insect species caught my attention recently, ants. This is often what's referred to as their autumn flight, and what we beekeepers would refer to as a swarm. My wife took a seat on this stone bench by our pond, only to have her legs quickly covered by these tiny orange workers. She didn't stick around for some reason, but I did, because I realized that this would be a great opportunity to capture this very interesting life cycle event. Those large ants with the wings are the newly produced queens, and the somewhat smaller, darker winged nestmates out there are the males, or in the bee world, what we would call drones. So how are ants and honeybees similar, you might be wondering? Well, they're both social insects. Both ants and bees are highly social, in fact, and they live in colonies with specialized roles for different individuals. They construct nests, either underground or in structures, to provide shelter and protection for their colonies. Honeybees, you might know, prefer tree cavities. This colony resides under this stone bench by a pond. If you wander around, you might find that other ant colonies are also swarming, as they tend to synchronize this event with all of the drones so they can mix it up with newly emerged queens from other colonies of the same species. And this strengthens genetic diversity, of course. Both insects are central place foragers, and that means that they return to a fixed nest site after they gather food and resources. They both share a common ancestor within the Hymenoptera order, so yes, honeybees and ants are related. Much like honeybee queens, these queens will fly into the air and mate with the males on the wing. How many males do they mate with? Well, let's just say that she mates with quite a few. Honeybee queens mate entirely on the wing, while these ant queens will begin their mating process in the air and then complete the process on leaves, grass stalks, or other areas where they can get a foothold. So you might come across this mating process later when you're looking around on the ground. What happens to the males after mating? I'm sure you want to know that. Well, in the case of honeybee drones, the drone dies after mating because he loses his reproductive organs in the process. And with the ants, the males just expire because they're not needed for any other purpose. That's all they're good for. And when a successfully mated queen lands somewhere nearby, she'll begin her own nest and begin her own colony. Honeybees must travel with workers in order to establish a new colony, but ant queens can do this completely on their own. Observing how poorly they fly, these queens aren't going very far at all. I tried to follow them and found that they land within 100 yards of this takeoff point. And the queen ant will chew off her own wings and excavate her new nest cavity, where she'll lay eggs that produce workers just like honeybees. They have four wings. These are likely to be Citronella ants. So what do they eat? Well, they primarily feed on honeydew, which is produced by aphids. Oh, why are they called Citronella ants, you might ask? Because they smell lemony, like citronella if you smash them. This time of year, their chances of completing this process and successfully starting a new colony are slim. There's so many birds and predatory insects that eat them. Did I mention that they're slow, awkward flyers? Flycatchers that we have, dragonflies, those are phoebes, even a fish just nabbed one in the background there. And many of our songbirds, they get a protein boost whenever these insects take to the air. So they're an extremely valuable food source item. And remember that while this colony is performing this behavior, there are others just like it, probably in the same field, just hundreds of feet apart. So this is a protein boost for everything from predatory insects on the wing to countless other birds. Even our nuthatches and woodpeckers eat them. I'm Frederick Dunn, and this has been a special episode of The Way to Be, and I want to thank you for watching, and I hope you learned something new.